e4 is e1 and is e2. Okay, for a given tree T in a graph G is a known tree is. So what are the known tree is? So these are the trees is e2, e1 and e4 are tree is, and e5 and e3 are known trees. Okay, so what are the frontier is? Frontiers is known, first of all, known tree is are e3 and e5. Okay. And according to definition, for a given tree in a graph G is a known tree is with end point in T1. So you can see that this is E3, one end point in T and other end point in not in T. But you can see that the edge E3, because this vertex is V4 and this vertex is V3, this vertex is V1 and this vertex is V2. Okay. So what are the frontiers? Means those known tree is whose end point in T1 and others end point is not T. Okay, others end point are not in T. It means that edge E3 has end point V4 and V3, and both V4 and V3 lie in V4 and V3 in T. Okay, so E3 is not frontier is. Now we check, is E5 is frontier is?
No, sir.
No, because end point of E5 are V3 and V1, and both are the end point of points lying in T. Got it? So with respect to this tree, there is no front edge. Got it? Okay. Now come to another example. I take this one. This is V4. This is V1. And it is edge E4. Suppose this graph is T2. Now you can see that T2 is a tree. Is it clear? T2 is tree or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
It is tree. With respect to tree T2, what are the known trees?
Sir, E3, E1, E5.
Known tree is with respect to T2. Okay. It is mentioned here. What are known trees?
E1, E3, E5.
E1, E3, E5, and
E2.
Okay. And frontier is
E1, E3, E2.
Now we check. Is E1 frontier is? E1 is frontier is?
Yes, sir.
Because E1 has endpoint. E1 has an endpoint V1 and V2. Okay, only one vertex is lying T2 and others vertex V2 is not lying T2. Got it? So E1 is frontier is. Is E3 frontier is?
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Because its end vertices are V4 and V3, and it has only one vertex which lies in T2. Okay. E5?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And E2?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No.
No, sir.
Because the end point of H2 is V2 and V3, and there is no vertex is lie in T2. Got it? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, move to another definition. Minimally connected graph. Minimally connected graph. Okay, so minimally connected graph. A graph is called a minimally connected. A graph G is called minimally connected if removal of any one edge the graph become disconnect from any one edge from G. Disconnect the graph. I think it is clear. You know what is the bridges? Example. Is it minimally connected graph? Is C4 minimally connected? No. Because if you remove any one edge, if you remove this edge, then we obtain a path. Okay, and suppose I take P3 here, P4 is minimally connected.
Yes, sir.
P4 is minimally connected.
Yes, sir.
Yes, because if we remove any one edge from the graph P4, this resulting graph become disconnect. Okay. Is it minimally connected?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Is it minimally connected?
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
It is not minimally connected.
Sir, not minimally connected.
Why?
Sir, if you remove any edge, then still it is connected.
No. If you remove this, this vertex and this edge will be here. Resulting graph will be like this way. So in this case, it is disconnected graph.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, tree models. Some tree models. Okay. First model. We can use structure of saturated hydrocarbons. Okay, now to enumerate the isomer. Isomers, you know what is the isomers of the compound of the form of saturated hydrocarbons. For example, suppose I have CH4. It is saturated hydrocarbons. Okay, so this can be represented in the like this form. So these vertex can be represented as hydrogen vertices, and this vertex can be represented as C. So this structure is the tree. Is it tree or not? Again, if you take C2, H2, C1, C, C, H, H. You can six. You can take six, you can take four. These are all hydro. Means what is the formula of C, N, H, 2N plus 2. This is the formula for the saturated hydrocarbons. Okay, so the structure of saturated hydrocarbons can be represented as a tree model. Second is, terminology of genealogical origins. What is the meaning of this? It means in the terminology of genealogical or origins, we can represent the terminology of families members like parents, children, siblings, etc. Or we can say that we can represent or we have a representation of terminology of parents, children, siblings. For example, this vertex represents a parents. Suppose this parent has two children, children one, children two, and this children has three children, C1, C2, C3, and suppose this child has no children. It is the meaning that this is the children of this vertex. So in this case, this vertex is the parents. Okay, same here. This vertex is the parents of these three children. Okay, so basically this is the representation of genealogical or origin in the form of tree. Okay, also we can use the tree in representing the organization. How? Okay, representing the structure of persons. The relation between the employee and boss. For example, in our BHU, VC is the main superpower in BHU. After VC, there are some pupils, some administrative pupils, which are working under the VC. These are the registrars. Okay, some is deputy registrar, some deputy registrar for academic, deputy registrar for e-state, deputy registrar of like this. And after deputy registrar, their heads are working in the supervision of deputy registrar. And in the head, there are faculties members. Okay, so such type of representation will be sound in the organization, in any organization. If suppose that organization is very large. Okay, so that organization can, in that organization, we can represent this structure in the form of tree. Computer file organization. You know very well about this. Computer files organization. You know, because files in the computer memory can be organized in the directory and subdirectory. For example, if we go any folders, what we direction we can use? First of all, we go into the this PC, then after we go to local disk, then after we go into the folder where you want to go into the file. For example, I go to the teaching work, and after teaching work there are a lot of folders in which there is a one folder which name is graph theory. Okay, like this way. So basically, so this representation, my PC, this people disk, BHU folder, teaching folder, graph theory. Okay, so this is the one directory of the organization of files. Okay, next we can use the tree in the network of parallel processor. Network for parallel processor. Okay, when we connect to interconnect the processor, we can also use the tree methods. And last one is the representing the organized data. Representing, or we can say that organizing organizing data. Okay, suppose we have a lot of data, then we can organize that data with the help of a tree. For example, suppose there are a river, then this river can be tributes and subtributes in many branches. Okay, so this representation of tributaries and subtributaries of a river we can represent in terms of a tree. Okay, and sorting of mails or a punch card, we can use the tree also. And arranging the sequence and subsequence, also we can use the tree theory. Okay, so it means that in daily practice, in the nature, there are a lot of applications of tree. Okay, and as you can see, the roadmap of BHU is also represent the tree structure. Okay. So these are the models. Means in these models we can use the tree. Clear? Clear?
Yes.
Hello? Okay. Okay. So I stop here. And
so Chan, what share kar dijiye.
हमें लग रहा है यही
मैं सर अपने अटेंडेंस ले लिए हैं हम
हाँ ले चुके हैं हम अटेंडेंस
हमारा रह गया सौरव सिंह
सौरव सिंह
यस तो नेटवर्क कनेक्टिविटी में प्रॉब्लम थी
बताइए रोल नंबर सौरव सिंह क्या है
रोल नंबर तो नहीं पता एग्जाम वाला पता है वही 25 है
सौरव सिंह कहाँ है सौरव सिंह 31 ओके
सर मेरा भी डायरेक्टर
नाम
राकेश मीनू
सर विष्णु गुप्ता सर
राकेश मीनू आपका अटेंडेंस ठीक है नेक्स्ट हो
सर विष्णु
सर विष्णु गुप्ता
विष्णु गुप्ता
सर लास्ट
आपका लग गया था
सुमन दे
आप तो पहली बार आए हो
मैं क्लास ज्वाइन करता था सर नेटवर्क का इशू हो जाता
है अगर नेटवर्क का इशू है देखिए इसमें कुछ स्टूडेंट ऐसे हैं जो कभी क्लास ही ज्वाइन नहीं करते जिनमें संजना कुमारी है सुमन देव हैं सौरव हैं ओके सौरव हैं सोनम हैं
सर मैं तो ज्वाइन करती हूँ और अटेंडेंस भी बोलती हूँ
सोनम
नो संजना
नाम हमने दिया ही नहीं है अभी ठीक है
फॉलो करता हूँ तुम्हें
संजना नहीं संजना का अभी आपका कंटिन्यूअस हुआ है अटेंडेंस लेकिन उससे पहले नहीं था कंटिन्यूअस
मेरा बीच में थोड़ा क्लास मिस हो गया था मैं बीच आए थे इसलिए
और इसमें आपका शुभम आज तक कोई अटेंडेंस नहीं है और ये रेनू हैं पूर्वी हैं वंदना हैं कौन आज बुलाया ना आपने अटेंड करें अटेंडेंस तो नहीं लगी आप लेफ्ट हो जाया करते होगे क्योंकि हम स्क्रीनशॉट लेते हैं जब आप अटेंडेंस आप क्लास होने के बाद सबका स्क्रीनशॉट लेते हैं जो अवेलेबल होता है सबके अटेंडेंस लगाते हैं
हेलो
सर ये जो फ्रंट पे जस्ट पढ़ाया था सर जरा उसमें वो वाली स्लाइड
ये है फ्रंट एरेज
यस सर जो इसमें जो फर्स्ट वाले उसके लिए निकाला वो एक बार फिर से बता दीजिए
ये देखिए ये ग्राफ जी है ठीक है इस ग्राफ के रेस्पेक्ट हमने कोई ट्री लिया टी अब इस ट्री के रेस्पेक्ट आपकी नॉन ट्री एज कौन सी हैं E3 और E5 हैं ओके नॉन ट्री एज ही फ्रंटियर एज होंगी जिनका एंड पॉइंट तो टी में हो और दूसरा टी में ना हो ओके सो ये दोनों एज ऐसी हैं इन दोनों का एंड पॉइंट टी में ही है T3 का भी इसमें है और T5 के भी एंड पॉइंट दोनों एंड पॉइंट इसी में है इसलिए कोई भी दोनों एज ये फ्रंटियर एज नहीं होंगी अगर हम इस एग्जांपल की बात करते हैं
सब जो बाकी बची हुई है वो फ्रंटियर होंगी
क्या
जो एजेस
डेफिनेशन क्या है फॉर ए गिवन ट्री इन ए ग्राफ जी इज ए नॉन ट्री एज. हमें ग्राफ चाहिए जी और टी चाहिए. इन दोनों के रेस्पेक्ट जो भी नॉन ट्री एज होंगी उनके रेस्पेक्ट ही हम एंड पॉइंट देखेंगे. बाकी एज तो ट्री एज है. इसमें देखिए E3 और E5 भी नॉन ट्री एज है. बाकी ये एज तीनों ट्री एज है. और डाउट किसी का डाउट हो तो बताइए.
तो स्लाइड शेयर कर दीजिए.
कर चुके हैं हम शेयर. ये आकांक्षा अब ज्वाइन कर रही हैं.